Hey, yo, what is good, YouTube? Today, we have a show and a half for you guys. We have the Hunger Games featuring your favorite Fire Emblem characters. We're going to be battling it out and seeing who will reign supreme among Fire Emblem's classic characters. In District 1, we have Dimitri and Edelgard, the unstoppable duo, two best of friends turned best of enemies. Let's see how they can survive. District 2, the Anna District. Anna from Fire Emblem Engage with Anna with from Fire Emblem Awakening. District 3, the Lovers District. Crom and Robin, two gay lovers, might have to turn their swords against one another in this on the battlefield. In District 4, we have the strong and indomitably willed Violent, along with his hot girlfriend Freya. How will they fare on the battlefield together? In District 5, we have the young swordsman Roy, paired up with the dog-ass tome user Guinevere. This is the worst legendary unit to ever be had in the game. Let's see if she can do a little bit better in the Hunger Games battlefield. In District 6, on the left, we have Ader. I hate this kid so much, I want to throw rocks at her. So to make her life even more miserable, I paired her up with the most diabolical man I know, Hugo Salamanca. In District 7, the lifelong rivalry between Peppa Pig and Lucina lives on. Will the antagonist of Peppa Pig's own show stab her in the back? In District 8, two famous, unnamed characters, perhaps too powerful to even be given identities, lest they be doxed. In District 9, the father and daughter duo, I think. Wait, no. In District 9, I don't know what they're... In District 9, the family duo of Sedith and Flayne. They have strong emotional connection towards each other. Perhaps we'll help each other out in this Hunger Games battlefield. Over in District 10, we have a fellow Fire Emblem Heroes YouTuber, DTM, being represented by his more well-known counterpart, a fucking car, as well as his one true love, the Bolt Tower, because we all know he wouldn't get very far in or in Aetherase without it. In District 11, we have the hottest Fire Emblem character known to man, Camilla. So who is worthy of being paired up with her? Why, it's dabuz, of course. And last but certainly not least, the two most iconic Fire Emblem characters I know of, Marth and Fi. So place your bets now. Who do you guys have winning this whole thing? Personally, I can't pick because I'm the commentator, but I leave your answer down in the comments. If you're right, I'll give you a cookie and I'll give you the hug. Let's do a chat favorite poll. Who do you guys got? There we have it. Bolt Tower is the chat favorite, brought to you by Connor Zach. Here we go, and we're off. As the tribute stand on their podiums, the horn sounds. Hugo Salamanca runs away. Not very like him. Kind of strange. Gatekeeper snatches a bottle and of alcohol in a rag. Wow, okay. So who knows whether he's wanting to drink or wanting to set some shit ablaze. We'll see. Freya runs away. Marth runs away. Bolt Tower runs away. I don't know how it does that. It's a tower. Flayne clutches a first aid kit. Oh my gosh, that is precious. She got that for Sedith. I'm sure of it. She wants to make sure that her brother is safe. Robin grabs a shield leaning on the cornucopia. He doesn't really use a shield, but we'll see how he does with it. Dimitri runs away. Ader runs into the cornucopia and hides. Dude, what a fucking pussy. This is why I hate her so much. What a pussy. Runs into the cornucopia? How stupid can you be? That's where everyone's gonna be. Hide? You can find a million better places to hide, dude. I'm kind of pissed off now. Peppa Pig stays at the cornucopia for resources. I hope she doesn't find Ader, because Peppa's slaying Ader in a second. Lucia runs away. Anna bashes Camilla's head in with a mace. We have our first blood. Leaving dabuz with nobody. Luckily, he grabs a trident from inside the cornucopia. Oh my goodness. Brutal. Sedith, Anna, DTM, and 313 archers share everything they gathered. Wow, okay. So a temporary alliance forming. Anna, that makes sense. She's always scheming. DTM, I don't know what he's quite doing. Sharing his resources, not quite like him, you know. Always a bit of a hoarder. Violent runs away. All right, good on him. Edelgard runs away. I think running away is a smart thing, personally. B runs away. Guinevere receives a trident. Okay, Guinevere and dabuz both armed with tridents here. Freya injures herself. Ooh, you hate to see it. I mean, when you're that scantily clad, right? I mean, it kind of makes sense for her. Hugo Salamanca thinks about home. Man, you know, he's got all the meth he could ever ask for back in Mexico. Guinevere fishes. I thought that was Flayne's thing, but go off, Guinevere. Okay. Dimitri goes hunting. Oh my god. I mean, I don't think there's any animals in the arena, so I'm assuming this means he's hunting for other people. We see Academy Dimitri on the picture, but I mean, the savage boar might be making an appearance here if this goes the right way. Crom, Fi, and Anna hunting for other tributes. Damn, no, I swear yesterday Anna was in an alliance with some other people. Now here she is teaming with Crom and Fi. She's everywhere, dude. Marth +20 avoid hiding himself in the bushes. Yeah. And gatekeep, let's see, exploring the arena. You know, that's very like him. There's no gate for him to keep, so he's just looking for some, you know? He needs to find a gate. He needs that purpose in life. Bolt Tower receives medical supplies from an unknown sponsor. Maybe patching up the walls or something real quick. All right, I like that. Ada receives explosives. Someone gave those explosives to her thinking she would just not know how to use them and like cut the wrong wire, and then just blows up in her face. I wouldn't be surprised if that happened, honestly. What a dumbass kid, dude. If you don't know why she's so sad all the time, it's because I ran over her dog. I'm not sorry about it either. Oh, let's see here. Anna sprains her ankle running away from Peppa Pig. Honestly, smart of her to run away. If I saw Peppa Pig charging towards me, I'd be running. There's no chance I'm winning that 1v1. Good on Anna, honestly. Sprains her ankle, but better than what she otherwise would have faced. Oh my god, and dabuz on the prowl. He knows he can take out the weak. DTM is the weak. He's preying on them, bro. Dabuz knows he's the man. Flame construction set as well. Oh, okay. She's just like playing Minecraft, dude. She gets the med kit, she gets the shack. She just doesn't want to hurt anyone. That's so adorable. Oh no, I feel kind of bad. Uh-oh. Marth and Tuco run into each other for the night and decide to truce? Whoa, okay. No, that's crazy. Tuco Salamanca making a truce with this twink? Tuco could snap him in half. Did Marth like have meth to give him or something? How did Marth pull that off? Peppa Pig and Guinevere huddle for warmth. Wow, so Anna ran away from Peppa Pig. Guinevere must have done something to get on her good side. That's impressive. I guess they got the similar drip, the red dress. They're rocking that. Oreo's awoken by nightmares. See, that's not the kind of thing you want to see if you're a Roy fan. Because, you know, this is the Hunger Games. You can't have that mental shakiness, right? You got to be focused. Robin, Anna, and DTM sleep in shifts. Wow, okay. Dude, the third Anna alliance. Oh my god, she is everyone. She's on everyone's side, dude. Dabuz receives explosives, dude. He's got that red Pikmin experience. Okay, no, that's a good... Whoever that sponsor is, they're smart. They know he'll know how to use them. Flynn and Kron talk about the tributes still alive. See, Flynn just wants to make friends, dude. Oh my gosh. When she dies, it's going to be tragic, you know? Because there's only going to be one winner. And I don't think you win the Hunger Games by playing this passive Minecraft-ass style gameplay. But she's going to try her hardest. When she dies, I might cry. Gatekeeper, Lucina, 313 Archer, and Freya sleeping in shifts. Wow, okay. Oh my goodness, look at this. The NPC duo teaming up with Lucina, Sedith, and Freya. Wow, okay. Keep in mind, Freya's still injured. She injured herself, so they might be taking care of her or something. If I was these dudes, I'd be taking care of her. That's for damn sure. You know what I'm saying? Dimitri, Fee, and Bolt Tower sleep in shifts. Again, I'm just gonna stop questioning how Bolt Tower, like, does human activities. I'm just gonna take it at face value. Oh my god, you have to be kidding me. This dumbass kid. Are you serious? What is her problem? She can't do anything right. She hasn't interacted with anyone and she's probably the closest to dying. No, I don't think she can win by doing absolutely nothing because she's gonna dive like, to the elements. She's gonna like fall out of a tree or some shit. Violent attempt to climb a tree but falls on Anna, killing them both. Oh no! Wow, Anna was the only one in the game so far with a kill with the mace to Camilla's head. But Violin takes her out at his own cost. Oh my god, the Chad Violin falls. I was just making fun of Aider saying she was going to fall out of a tree. What is this? Oh, Freya injures herself again. And Guinevere running away from Peppa Pig. Wait, yesterday they was cuddling together or something. What happened between them? Peppa Pig is a menace, dude. That is the second person to run in fear from Peppa Pig. No one is safe. Gatekeeper decides it was a cave. Okay. He found a gate to keep. He puts a gate up in front of the cave. He's good. Oh, this is huge for Gatekeeper, dude. His purpose in life. Oh, and Flame gets more medical supplies. Dude, some sponsors saw how innocent she was. They saw that. They respected it. They said, okay, you know what, Flame? I'll give it up for you. Sedith tends to Anna's wounds. Oh, Anna was wounded. This is Anna's influence yet again, dude. Making Sedith do her bidding. Healing her up real quick. Dimitri sets off an explosive, killing Lucina, Tuco, Bolt Tower, and Fee. Dude, the three chat favorites in one bomb from Dimitri sets them all ablaze. And Lucina as well. Bolt Tower, the chat favorite, crumbles to the likes of Dimitri. This has huge influence on DTM as well, because what's he going to do without his trusty Bolt Tower? He's doomed. He killed every last one of them. Huge play from Dimitri. What's the buzz up to? Practicing his archery. Yeah, whatever. But he's honing his skills. He heard about what's happened to Tuco. He's like,
Marth and Aider split up to search for resources. Dude, what kind of dumbass is Marth to team up with Aider? Excuse me? Oh, man. Does he want to win the game? Ugh. He could be using Aider. That's a good point. Like, as a pawn, maybe? Sends her in, like, a minefield to test it out for him? Yeah. 6 cannon shots. Wow, so many chat favorites all in one fell swoop. Violent, Anna, Lucina, Tuco Salamanca, Bolt Tower, and Fee all perish. Guinevere climbs a tree. Good for her. Oh my, dude, this is, I can't believe this. Flynn and Roy hold hands. That is adorable. Flynn does not want to see anyone hurt. She doesn't want to be here. What sicko put Flynn in this thing? What sicko put Flynn in the same arena as Tuco Salamanca? That's fucked, dude. She doesn't, so can we just get her out of here? Someone send in a chopper and get her out of here. She's too precious. Peppa Pig sees a fire but stays hidden. Wow, she's on the prowl, okay. Who has a fire? Uh-oh. That's who has a fire. This could have been disastrous for dabuz. Oh no! DTMs! That's an explosive killing set of Aider, 313 Archer, and Dimitri? No way! Dude, Dimitri just prior sets off an explosive healing 4, but DTM claps right back, getting Dimitri. And Aider, you know what? I think we were right about Marth teaming up with her for ill-gotten gains, because maybe I'm feeling Marth sent Aider into like the explosive area just to test it out, right? Aider gets in there, boom! On the bright side, Aider is dead, so we can celebrate. We can raise a glass to that. Hey, Freya, Edelgard, Gatekeeper, Robin, and Anna sleep in ships. Wow. Okay, so a massive, and Anna again in the middle of some random new team that's created. Every single alliance that's created, Anna's in the center of it, dude. Yeah, Anna might just live to the end just because no one wants to kill her. She's been helping everyone out, it seems. Never mind. Oh my god, she did something to piss off Robin, I guess. Uh-oh. Flynn runs away from Crom. Oh no. She was like, that's a big scary man. I do not want anything to do with him. Oh no. Oh my god, Roy begs for Edelgard to kill him, but she refuses keeping Roy alive. Oh. Roy was suffering those nightmares earlier. I think we're seeing the repercussions of that. His mental health is declining right now. Dabuz is well getting a hatchet. Okay, dude. He's gathering his resources. That's perfect resource management from Dabuz. That's exactly what you expect to see from it. He's grinding, perfect Pikmin and resource management. I think we're gonna see him go far. Here's 4 cannon shots from DTM's crazy quad kill. Seteth, Aider, 313 Archer, and Dimitri. Everyone F's in the chat. Flynn setting up camp. Oh my goodness. She's playing Minecraft. She's not playing the same game as everyone else, dude. Oh my gosh. Wow, Guinevere overpowers Anna. We saw earlier, I think it was Guinevere that ran from Anna, but Guinevere turns around and says, nuh-uh, I'm not gonna fall for your two-timing bitch face anymore. Smacks her one. Gives, oh my god, kills a child. Maybe in Heroes, if Guinevere dropped her tome, became like a gauntlets user or something, she'd actually start doing something. Crom fends Roy, Freya, and DTM away from his fire. Wow, single-handedly. Fends them away. It looks like no one was out for blood here. They just want to steal his fire, I guess. Can't Roy like create fire at will? Oh no, this is the first Dabuz L we've seen, guys. Between all of his skills, man, he's crazy with a bow. He's got a hatchet. He's got all these resources, but no. When it comes to fire, he's kaput. Ooh, Guinevere steals from Marth. Guinevere's being a way bigger contender than I initially thought. I thought her Fire Emblem hero skills are 0 to none, but here in the Hunger Games, when it comes to survival, she knows what's up. Oh no. Oh, something snapped in Flynn. He's with Roy too. You know what I think happened? I think Roy and Flynn, earlier they were holding hands. I feel like these two had a heart to heart. They really talked through differences. Said, you know what? We're not gonna win this thing just by sitting around and being scared. We have to get on the hunt. That's what we have to do. We have to kill. They roped Freya in. Here they go. Let's see, the Anna, the one death. Oh man, Guinevere was not taking her shit. Big events! Gatekeeper, Flynn, Robin, and Peppa Pig sleeping in shifts. Okay, there's one. Flynn and Roy taking a short break from each other. But Dabuz fending off Roy, Marth, and DTM. Oh my god, he does that by himself! He set up that fire, you know? He said, fuck it, I can start a fire. He starts that shit up and people try to steal it. He says, no, get away from my fire. DTM's been kicked out of like 10 groups now. Ain't nobody wants his bitch ass. Probably because they're not never successful. Look at this. Let's see. Peppa Pig, Freya, Guinevere, Edelgard, and Robin. Oh my god. All on a team now? What is going on? Teams are being formed and disbanded faster than I can think. But right below it, Crom attacks Gatekeeper. Oh my god. Dude, Crom sucks. Has he didn't he kill anyone?
Oh shit. Dude, some sponsor saw the character development in Flame. They said, I got you, homie. Gave her some explosives. Oh, will she use them though? Something snapped in Flame and she's going crazy now. I would love to see her use these. Maybe get some kills on the board for her. Let's see. Roy scares the buzz off. Damn, okay. Roy went, bah! The buzz, ah! No one dies. We might have to have some intervention here. Not yet, though. As dabuz receives some food, everyone's supporting dabuz, dude. These sponsors are team dabuz, and I can't say I blame them. The King of New York. Wow, I'm kind of surprised at how few people can start a fire. It doesn't seem that hard. I feel like if I was training for the Hunger Games, the first thing I would do is learn how to start a fire. I mean, come on. Oh! Robin falls into a frozen lake and drowns. Well, that kind of sucks for him. Crom is left alone. That's so sad because Crom will never know what happens to his lover. This strategy was not very grand at all, dude. Oh, Guinevere's trap kills Edelgard. Whoa, Edelgard was like huge contender. They were on a team just yesterday. This could have been an accidental kill for all we know. Trap? Guinevere's setting up traps and shit since when? She's really showing her survival prowess in this. They gotta make her a gauntlet user in the next Heroes alt or something, dude. DTM getting fresh food from a sponsor. This must be Phaology or something. Phaology saw how shit DTM was doing. He's like, don't worry about it. I got you. Gives him some food and shit. Crom is so sad thinking about where Robin is. He can't sleep properly. He has to sing himself to sleep. Oh, man. You hate to see it. And oh, no. Flame treats her infection. How would she get infected? Gatekeeper falls into a pit and dies. Okay, well, I was kind of hoping for something a little more epic for Gatekeeper, but... Look at this right below. Freya and dabuz. Dude, low-key, dabuz heard about Camilla's death early on. He's like, I gotta find myself a new baddie. Searches out Freya. Hey, let's go hunting, babe. He's okay, the Riz Master right now. I see you, dabuz. Marth scares Crom off. Whoa, okay. Roy decapitates Guinevere with a sword. I take back every good thing I said about her. Roy just takes it off of her. This mentally unstable child can defeat her. They're from the same game. He's a traitor. What's up with that? New King of Burn. There we go. New King crowned. It's Roy. Yay. Oh, no. Dude, she finally started going on the hunt and she says, I can't do this anymore, dude. Oh no. As soon as she started killing people, she was like, no. She didn't even kill anyone, but she like tried to. And now she's all fucked up. Oh my god. Four dead. Robin, Edelgard, Gatekeeper, and Guinevere. Oh, but dabuz overpowers Roy, killing him. That's a kill on the board for dabuz. That grind session finally pays off for him. Getting a kill on Roy, a mentally unstable child who just killed Guinevere, who was one of the strongest ones in the game. dabuz is not only the King of New York, but he's the King of Burn, baby. That's right. He took it from Roy, who took it from Guinevere. And what's going on here? Okay, Freya tending to Peppa Pig's wounds. Oh my god, this is precious. Crom defeats Flint in a fight, but spares her life. Good. Thank goodness. Oh my god, Crom has a heart. It was definitely Flame who saw him and like scaredly tried to defend herself. Like she thought there was no other choice and like she tried to like fight him off. And he beat her obviously, but like he said, no, I can't kill her. She wouldn't hurt a fly. Oh my gosh. Marth questions his sanity. He has no idea what's going on. Oh my god! dabuz bashes Crom's head in with a mace! Wait, right below it, Flame catches DTM off guard and I am in disbelief. We have yesterday, Crom sparing Flame in a fight. And the very next day, Crom dies at the hands of dabuz. And it's Flame who's the one who gets a kill on DTM. Who's been showing up like crazy this match. What snapped in Flame after that fight? That is unbelievable. The very next day, Flame gets a kill and Crom dies. Oh, I can't believe that. Let's see. Let's see, Marth and Freya get into a fight over raw meat, but Marth gives up and runs away. This is the feast, by the way, when the cornucopia is replenished. So they both see some raw meat, they both want it, but Marth gives up. Looks like Freya gets it. Good for her. She's eating good tonight, that's for damn sure. Oh, and Peppa Pig dies from infection. Yikes, dude. I think Freya was trying to tend to her wounds yesterday. I guess she did a shit job.
Because Peppa's fucking dead now. Looks like we're down to our final, what, four? Down to our final four. Wait a minute. Flayne runs away from Marth, but dabuz is unable to convince Freya not to kill him. And it looks like dabuz, who tried so ever hard to riz up Freya, is in the end unsuccessful as she killed him. Oh no, dude. Is Riz too good for his own good? And Freya, unbelievable, is able to get one over on dabuz. Ultra rare dabuz L. But you know what? We're down to our final three, this looks like. Flayne, against all odds, makes it to the final three, along with Marth and Freya. Against all odds. The first half of the game does absolutely nothing, playing her own thing. But finally, she snaps. Freya, been playing the whore the whole time, trying to be the Buzz's side hoe. After the death of Camilla, ultimately betrays him and takes his life. And Marth, of course, he's Marth. I think if anything, he's been the Luigi of this game. He's the one who might try to win by doing absolutely nothing. Because Flayne's been trying to showing her hand a little bit, being like, oh yeah, I really don't know what I'm doing out here. That's been Flayne, right? But Marth, I think he does stand a chance. He's just been holding back. Let's see what happens. Five dead. Roy, Crom, DTM, Peppa, and dabuz. Pour one out, guys. This could be the final day here. Let's see. Freya, oh no, catches Flayne off guard and kills her. And Marth perishing from hunger. Oh, what a dumbass. He wasn't hiding anything at all. He was just stupid. He doesn't know how to play the Hunger Games. Oh no, Freya catching Flayne off guard. Oh, she turned her back for 1 second and Freya sinks her teeth into her. Oh man, it looks like Freya is the winner. Originally with Violent, ends up with dabuz and betrays him to take the whole game. Kills Flayne in the end. Not a very hard, difficult task. Honestly, her, the win was kind of handed to her. All she had to do was kill the weakest Link. Marth took care of himself. Let's see who had the most kills. DTM with 4, my goodness. On a rampage, as well as Dimitri, killed every last one of them. Maybe if Flayne's preference weapon was better, she could have gotten that the edge up on Freya there, but no. Looks like the hottest character in Fae, Freya takes it. I mean, just look at her. Tell me I'm wrong. Leave a comment if you disagree, because I'm going to bully you if you do disagree. You know what I'm saying? Did your favorite win? Leave a comment below and let me know. Dimitri did a 9-11 on the bull.